Accepting comes in circles, I think. It is just a process of open circling through objects, through stories, through personalities. And me as an artist, I have chosen to actually continue to build a lifelong collection of my personal artwork, which is a privilege, but an effort too, actually. If I were not an artist, I would be a collector of contemporary art, I guess. Collectors do follow us artists in our research, and they do personalize and adapt and recontextualize according their personality, according their taste and their spaces. Last year I came across a beautiful collection of small figurines that were displayed, positioned in the bookshelves of an antiquarian bookstore. These animal statuettes, creatures and different materials were strong enough to raise a question and to make me paint. The question was, how comes all these animal figurines are asked to hold these books, or to are they supposed to question them? Libri Antichi Stampe, the book ends, is the series of paper, of works on paper that I made of this encounter. A much larger collection served me as an inspiration for Paradise. The bitten apple being passed from Eve onto Adam. This sensually ambiguous and metaphorically loaded image that I found in the Lukas Cranach, the digital Cranach archive, an online resource, made me paint and repaint, appropriate the bitten apple. And not only paint it, but bite the apple myself with my brush. And this brings me to my all-time favorite collection, the 243 wax fruits done by Father Keller in Stift Admont, in the heart of Austria. But apart from my personal artistic work, I do have a collection of strange objects that I have been assembling over the last decades, I would say. First of all, die Puppe für Bauchredner. I was still not resolved her enigma. I don't know how she is supposed to work. Another one is this metal object. It might have to do something with beekeeping and with smoke. Who knows? I do collect glass eyes, antique glass eyes. And I can't stop looking at them. I started collecting glass eyes when I got to know Carol Rama's work. And to end with an anecdote, in the beginning of this week I got stuck in Bergamo and I visited Accademia Carrara with its wonderful collection of old Italian masterpieces. And what I saw there is a Santa Lucia from 1527. This play of gazes is exactly what could be the start of a new work.